Beatriz is a holistic healer, and she goes to a house to give a massage to a client that she's had for a very long time. And she gets stuck in that house where there's going to be a very important dinner. And she gets kind of invited out of pity, and it's a disaster. First, she's very excited to be with these people, and then it becomes a disaster. What resonated, so many things resonated to me about this film. The subtlety also, in which all those things are treated in such elegance. It's wonderful. One of the things, of course, the political climate in America, although we started this project before this political climate, that it's not just in America, the division of two philosophies in the countries that are becoming more and more palpable, and they're separating more and more. The film talks about that. The film talks about also this human nostalgia. It talks about being an immigrant and this human nostalgia that we all have in different ways, trying to think of that place where life was perfect, and whether you're an immigrant or not. And it's about how it's not really a place itself, but it's going back to who you were once in that place, and where you were innocent and pure. And the more she's disgusted with the people in the dinner, the more she misses this place. It's making no sense. But when you see it, it's going to make a lot of sense.
And just ask about working with John on the other side of that.
John, he's genius. He's an adorable counterpart. I'm not going to say villain, because depending who's watching the film, there's going to be some people who are going to think I'm the villain. But he's a legend to me. And I was so lucky to be able to watch him in action and study, you know, everything he did, because I was watching him like a hawk, and to be able to play with him. And I just feel so privileged, not just because of John, but because of the level of talent involved in the film.
What was it like working with Miguel?
Nirvana. It's like one of the best, most amazing experiences of my life. He's such a good actor, director, so kind, so much fun, and so talented. You know, even if he was a monster, I still would have been so excited to work with such a talent. And of course, we were very spoiled, because the script, it's also wonderful, written by Mike White. There he goes somewhere, and he's a genius too. So I really pinch myself. I'm very, very lucky with this one. Before, you know, I would have done anything with these two, Miguel Arteta and Mike White. I'm a huge fan. They're good friends. When they told me they were doing this project and they had me in mind, I didn't realize that I was the lead. And they wouldn't tell me much about it, and they told me that it was a dinner, and I thought in my head, for sure I'm the cook or the servant, or, you know, I'm walking in and out in two scenes, and I'm so excited I get to work with him. And we talked a lot about it. We spent a whole afternoon and a night together talking about it, 2 weeks before my birthday, and he hadn't started writing anything. He was just, you know. And the day of my birthday, I got an email from Mike White that said, happy birthday. He wrote in 2 weeks. And when I read this best birthday gift ever, I mean, I went crazy. I think it would have been important 10 years ago. But, and it will probably still be important 10 years from now. But I think that in the political climate, not only of the United States, but around the world, where we are seeing countries dividing philosophies more and more and stronger, the movie is very timely, because it's about two different points of view coming together by chance and not really being able to communicate. Trump was not born yesterday. These kind of characters exist It's just the shock is now one is the president of the United States. But they've been around for a long time. I mean, he was thinking of the dentist that killed the lion. And we were appalled by that. And of course, while we were shooting it, or right after, we saw the sons of Trump with the leopards. And but at the time, we didn't know. But there's a lot of truth in the movie, and so that's why it's similar to real life. I come to the Sundance Film Festival in London. I do all sorts of things. It was such a beautiful day today. I was so excited. I had to change my dress because I said, oh, I have a cold, and it's for sure it's going to be freezing, and it's going to rain. And I woke up, and the birds were singing louder, because that's the beautiful thing about London. The birds don't care about the weather. The British birds are always happy to sing beautifully every morning, even with the bad weather. So I get my inspiration to enjoy every day, regardless of the weather, from them. But today was gorgeous.